गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई वेलकम यू टू माय चैनल सब्सक्राइब विद एनकेएस। एज यू नो दैट दिस इज द राइट प्लेटफॉर्म फॉर सोशल साइंस एंड स्टूडेंट्स, लॉट ऑफ वीडियोस ऑफ क्लास 6 टू 12 आर ऑलरेडी अपलोडेड, सो यू कैन सब्सक्राइब दिस चैनल, शेयर दिस वीडियोस एंड अबाउट द लाइक दिस वीडियोस एंड गिव योर वैल्यूएबल कमेंट्स टू ऐड मोर इंफॉर्मेटिव कंटेंट्स इन दिस चैनल, सो दैट विल हेल्पफुल फॉर यू फॉर मोर इन द कमिंग डेज। So let's start our today's class. So student, in the last video we have completed till the fourth chapter of class 7 history. So today we are going to continue the next topics of class 7 geography. Because in the last classes of the geography class we have discussed half of the topic of our changing path. Correct? So third chapter of geography name is our changing path. Okay, so student, this chapter we'll start a new topic of this chapter. So those who have not seen the previous video where we have discussed about the earthquake, volcano, then you can see those videos, so it will helpful for you. So student, in this topic we'll discuss about the major landforms, correct? Okay, so student, the major landform, as you know that we'll discuss about the river and about the work of a river and about the other things one by one. So in today's video, we'll first discuss about the walls of a river. So before that, in the major landforms, I will discuss that weathering and erosion. These are the two parts through which landscape is being continuously worn away. So two things are there, weathering and erosion, correct? So student, weathering and erosion, first we discuss about the weathering. Weathering and erosion are two parts through which the landscape is being continuously worn away. So weathering is the breaking of the rocks on the earth surface. So weathering is the breaking of the rocks on the earth surface. Okay, so weathering is the breaking of the rocks on the earth surface. Correct. So next we will discuss about the erosion. What is erosion? Okay, so in the erosion we discuss about that erosion is the wearing away of the landscape by different agents. So erosion is the wearing away of the landscape by different agents like water, wind and ice. So the eroded materials carried away or transported by the water etc. and eventually deposited. So the process of erosion and deposition create different landforms on the surface of the earth. So erosion is the wearing away of the landscape by different agents like water, wind and ice. Okay, so erosion is the wearing away of the landscape. Erosion is the wearing away of the earth's surface by different agents like wind, water and ice. Correct? So we'll discuss about that. Just now I have written here the definition. Erosion is the wearing away of the landscape by different by different agents like water, wind and air, correct? So in this, by this way, what happened? The eroded material, the because of this erosion, the eroded materials carried away and transported by water and about wind. So and eventually they deposited the thing which are eroded and transported, the eroded material they deposited because of the flowing of the water and air, and they gathered in one place. So this process of erosion and deposition, they create a different landforms on the surface of the earth. Okay, so now we will discuss about because of the erosion, how the walls of a river. Next we will discuss about the walls of a river, correct? Okay, so student, the walls of a river, okay? Now we will discuss about in a diagram about different important things of related to the walls of a river, correct? Suppose here I am drawing one river, okay? So in this we will refer about the features made a river in a flood plain. Okay, features made a river in a flood plain. So this is the diagram of features made a river in flood plain. Okay, so now we'll discuss about different important things here. Okay, about the different important point now we are going to discuss here, and if during all this thing it will help us to understand about the different important things related to the walls of the river. Okay. Okay, so student, you know this is the meander. Okay, this is meander. So the definition I will tell you just after that. Just find out, I am just writing about the different important keyword. This is meander, this is oxbow lake, okay, and this is, so this I will write about the levees, okay. And next I will tell you oxbow lakes, meander, levees, all this I have written. Then next I will write about a different diagram. Just write down this, a different diagram. This is the main river and some of the rivers are joining here. Okay. So here what will happen, this is the, now we will discuss about a new thing. So this is the main river, okay, main river, and in this main river so many tributaries are joined, and this is the delta. Okay, so let's discuss in detail about this diagram, correct? So first we will discuss about rivers have a role in the evolution and various landform. So rivers have a great role in the erosion, erosion and the evolution of various landforms. So in different landforms are created by the works of the, by the works of river. So different landforms are created by the work of a river, different work of a river. So when the river tumbles a steep angle and very land rocks एंड ओवर वेरी हार्ड रॉक और डाउन ए स्टीप वैली साइड इट फॉर्म्स ए वाटरफॉल. सो व्हाट हैपेंड, व्हाट इज वाटरफॉल? सो व्हेन द रिवर टंबल, टंबल मीन्स जस्ट टर्न अवे और टू फॉल डाउन. ओके, व्हेन ए रिवर टंबल, टंबल एट ए स्टीप. ओके, स्टीप मीन्स राइजिंग और फॉलिंग. स्टीप मीन्स राइजिंग और फॉलिंग. सो व्हेन ए रिवर इज फॉलिंग इन ए स्टीप, ओके, व्हेन ए रिवर इज टंबल एट स्टीप एंगल ओवर हार्ड रॉक्स और डाउन ए स्टीप वैली साइड इट फॉर्म्स ए वाटरफॉल. सो आई होप यू ऑल हैव सीन द वाटरफॉल. वाटरफॉल मीन दैट इज ए स्टीप. ओके, स्टीप मीन्स टू डाउन, इट मीन्स टू फॉलिंग डाउन. ओके, स्टीप मीन्स एनीथिंग हु राइज और फॉलिंग. सो वाटरफॉल इट मीन्स वॉट हैपन वेन द रिवर टंबल्स इन ए स्टीप इन द वेरी हार्ड रॉक. करेक्ट, दैट इज वाटरफॉल. नेक्स्ट मीएंडर. मीएंडर इज ए लार्ज बैंड. मीएंडर यू कैन सी दैट दिस इज द लार्ज बैंड, दिस इज मीएंडर. यू कैन सी इन दिस प्लेस द वाटर इज बैंड, द रिवर इज फ्लोइंग बैंडली. सो इन दिस मीएंडर इज ए लार्ज बैंड फॉर्म बाय द ट्विस्टिंग एंड टर्निंग ऑफ द रिवर. ओके, मीएंडर मीन्स इट इज ए लार्ज बैंड बिकॉज ऑफ द ट्विस्टिंग फॉर्म बाय द ट्विस्टिंग एंड टर्निंग ऑफ द रिवर वाइल एंटरिंग द प्लेन, एंटरिंग एनी प्लेन प्लेस. सो यू कैन सी दिस, इट इज ए ट्विस्टिंग एंड टर्निंग ऑफ ए रिवर इन ए प्लेस. ओके, व्हेन एंटरिंग द प्लेन. ओके, सो नेक्स्ट वाज व्हाइल द नेक्स्ट वी डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाइल द कंटिन्यूअस इवोल्यूशन एंड डिपोजिशन. सो व्हाइल सो विद द कंटिन्यूअस इरोजन एंड डिपोजिशन. सो कंटिन्यूअस इरोजन एंड डिपोजिशन अलोंग द साइड्स ऑफ द मेंडर. ओके, सो कंटिन्यूअस इरोजन एंड डिपोजिशन इन द साइड ऑफ द मेंडर. द एंड्स ऑफ द मेंडर लूप, द एंड्स ऑफ द मेंडर लूप वेरी क्लोजर एज द टाइम पासेस अवे. द मेंडर लूप कॉर्ड्स ऑफ फ्रॉम द रिवर एंड फॉर्म ए कॉट ऑफ लेक ऑल्सो कॉल्ड ऑक्सबो लेक. सो अगेन आई एम टेलिंग यू, सो यू कैन सी हियर विद द कॉमन इरोजन एंड डिपोजिशन. सो विद द कंटिन्यूस इरोजन एंड डिपोजिशन अलोंग द साइड्स ऑफ द मेंडर, द एंड्स ऑफ द मेंडर लूप वेरी क्लोजर टू द टाइम पासेस अवे. द मेंडर लूप कॉर्ड्स ऑफ फ्रॉम द रिवर एंड फॉर्म्स ऑफ ए लेक. सो बिकॉज ऑफ द कंटिन्यूस इन दिस मेंडर लूप, बिकॉज व्हेन इट टर्न्स अवे, इट टर्न्स हियर, समथिंग इज क्रिएट प्रॉब्लम him, that is why it talks. So after erosion and deposition continuously for years, what happened? This water separately from this water and entering this place. So when it entering this place, a small lake created in this place, that is known as the Oxbow Lake. Correct? So next we'll discuss about the flood plain. Okay, so flood plain is a flower fertile plain formed by the deposition of fine soil and other materials that is sediments through the flood water. Okay, so flood plain is a flood plain formed by the deposition of fine soil materials or sediments through the flood water. So as we have created here, you can see that these are all the river, these are the rivers, and these places are formed by the flood plain. Okay, these are the flood plain. Correct. Next, we'll discuss about the next one. Levees. What is levees? Levees are the raised banks of the river. I hope we all have must gone to the river for bathing for any other purpose, to see the river and spend the evening hours near the bank of the river. So what happened? Levees are the raised banks of the river. So you can see that these are the banks. Okay, these are the river and this is the banks. Okay, so these banks are the levees, known as the levees. Okay, so levees are the raised banks of the rivers. Okay, Next we'll discuss about the next point, the tributaries. You can see that this is tributary. Now we'll discuss about the tributary. Correct? So tributaries are the numbers of streams which distribute the river water. It became when the river approaches the sea. So the speed of flowing water decreases and river begins to break up. The river becomes so slow that it begins to deposit its load. Each distributary forms its own mouth. Okay. So just now I am repeating that again. The distributary. Distributaries are the number of streams, number of the branches of a river. Okay, which distribute the river water. It means these streams are distributed the river water. It is because when river approaches the sea, the speed of flowing water decreases and river begins to break up. So the speed of flowing water decreases. When the speed of a flowing water decreases and river break up, so what happened? Then the river becomes slow. It begins to deposit its load. Each distributary forms its own mouth. Okay. So you can see that. So when any area it becomes slow, then it separates. Okay. These are the tributary and this is the main river. Okay. So that is what just I said, that distributary are the number of streams which distribute the river water. It is because when the river approaches the sea, the speed of flowing water decreases and rivers begins to break up. Okay. When the speed will break up, when a river is flowing, its speed is broken up, it means it will just separate the new streams. Okay. Then it will create in different branches. Okay. Then it begins to deposit its load. Each distributary forms its own mouth. Correct. Next is delta. Delta is formed by the deposition of sediments carried by a river as the flow leaves its mouth. Okay. So delta is formed by the deposition of sediments carried by a river as the flow leaves its mouth. So you can see here, this delta is formed by the deposition of sediments. You can see these are the delta, these are tributary, main river, these are the delta. This delta is formed by the sediments which are carried by a river as the flow leaves its mouth. Correct. So student, in this class we have discussed about the major landforms and about the erosion and about the deposition along with the works of a river. So in the next class we will discuss about the sea caps. Thank you for watching this video, and subscribe and like and share this video with your friend, those who are reading NCERT. We will meet with you next class. Thank you.